Are you the person who has summoned me? What business do you have with me? A contract? Very well. And what is it that you desire? How strange. Nothing. Your goal is just familiar. It reminds me of someone else's. And you realize the price that you will have to pay, correct? Good. You've done your research. Though, I wonder if you did it well enough. Making a deal with a demon is no light task. I'm not implying that you don't know what you're doing. I'm simply saying that there are other options. Some people often regret making deals with demons. Many of them do, in fact. They end up begging for their lives. Oh? Good. I doubt I'd even have the patience to put up with it. Excuse me? No. You said something. What was it? You said that there was a reason you wouldn't be afraid. You think that I am a child? Demons age differently than humans. I may look like a child, but believe me, I am more powerful than you could ever hope to be in your lifetime. You dare speak to me in that tone? I hope you realize that I have the power to tear your soul from your body, right here, right now. I could devour it while you watch on in horror. I could make it agonizing for you. I could. But I won't. And do you know why? Because I am mature. I've learned from past mistakes. Unlike most humans, I have the opportunity to think about my actions long after they've been performed. And I know that it's not quite as satisfying stealing someone's soul. When you steal it, their fear affects the flavor turns it bitter, sometimes even bland. No demon looks forward to a meal like that. But when you make a contract with someone, help them fulfill their goal. Then at the end of their life, they're satisfied. Usually, their minds are at peace. And sometimes, very rarely, they'll be grateful to the demon who helped them. In those cases, their soul gains a rather sweet flavor that I've grown fond of. And of course, if given the choice between sweet or bitter, it's easy to choose. Don't think about backing out now. Any other demon you'd find wouldn't be nearly as... oh, how should I put it? As forgiving as I would be. You see, I wasn't always a demon. I was once human like you. I made a contract with a demon. My parents were killed when I was young, and I sought revenge on the people that murdered them. My lust for revenge and my contract with a demon led to someone else turning me into a demon. And thus, I was cast into an eternal hell. There are a few positive aspects, but overall, I see the consequences of my desires. My desires for revenge. My desires to keep hatred close to my heart. Lock away all other emotions and throw away the key. Other demons don't have regrets, because they don't lose anything that they want to hold on to. But I did. I lost my humanity. I essentially lost my soul. And now, I'm forced to serve others who are just like me. So if you choose to back out of this deal with me, the only other demons you could find, odds are they would treat you terribly. They might ignore you whenever possible. Treat you as if you're beneath them, and only ever view you as a meal being prepared for them. I understand what it's like to be looked at that way. It was relatively easy to ignore, but it can get on people's nerves. So if you don't want that, if you want a demon with just a bit of humanity left within them, I recommend you address me with more respect and make a contract with me. Very well then, Master. Think about a part of your body. Just do it. Do you see the seal on my hand? That is our contract seal. Whatever part of your body you think of, that's where yours will appear. The more visible, the stronger our connection is. But don't be tempted, because that can make it more difficult to hide from regular humans. And sometimes, other demons will want you because of the connections you have. All right. Now, you may choose a name for me. It can be any name you like. Well, when I was a human, my name was CL Phantom Hive. You've heard of me? How interesting. You wish for me to keep that name? As you wish, Master.